Hey everyone, and welcome back to the X-Ring. We have an exciting episode today, and especially if you're into hunting, you're gonna wanna know about this rifle. This rifle has not been released yet in the United States. It has been for sale in Europe about 5 months or so, but it's something that I think that will do really well on the US market. This will probably be available after SHOT Show this year. Well, you'd probably see it in spring of 2024. So what we're looking at today, this rifle is made by LIWA Arms in Slovakia, and it is called the Cheyah Z20 or Z20. It is a straight pull action. So what we're going to do is we're going to start at the back and work our way forwards and talk about some of the features that it has. I will tell you that I've never owned a straight pull centerfire rifle, but it's one of those that I'm very interested in. I do remember when Savage released their straight pull to the US market, and I don't know how that well that did, but I definitely think this is more of a refined product. So starting at the back, you do have this recoil pad here. It does have good grip to it, so it's not going to slip, especially in inclement weather or rain. It does have their own unique design on this beautifully laminated stock here. The stock fits really well. It has some really good checkering in the palm swells as well as along the top on the forend here. So it's not that slick design that you might see out of a lot of hunting rifles. Now this straight pull action is extremely smooth. It is a box fed system. This should hold 4 or 5 rounds depending on the caliber, and it should be available in not only 308 Winchester, but also 6.5 Creedmoor. So we're gonna be shooting the 6.5 Creedmoor today, and I'm gonna give you some close-ups and talk a little bit more about the action. So if you're not familiar with a straight pull, one of the huge advantages of a straight pull design is how fast you can cycle the action. Now, that might not be a big deal if you're shooting whitetail or something like that, because follow-up shots might not be necessary. But in Europe, where they do a lot of hog hunting, or even in Texas or places like that, and I know you guys might be using a semi-automatic, something like an AR or 300 Blackout, this, I believe, has a place in the US market. So it is as simple as pulling it back and forwards, and you're ready with your next shot. So you're eliminating quite a few steps. You're not lifting the bolt, bringing it back, moving it back forwards, and then pushing it back down. We're also not canting the rifle by working that bolt, especially if you have something that's a short throw, like a 60 degree or something like that. It's pretty easy to work this straight without upsetting the cant of the rifle. Everything straight to the rear and straight back forwards. You do have a really nice, clean-looking safety lever here that just moves to the left to engage the safety, and you can actually see the firing pin mechanism on the back. Now on the left side here, you do have the bolt release, and all we have to do on that is just press downwards on it and the bolt is going to come out. You'll still see that it has a locking lug design. This is a 3-lug design and it is a very robust mechanism. I'll give you some up close video of that here in just a moment. So getting it back in place is as simple as pushing that bolt release, and we're getting everything lined up. Give me just a second. Probably have to get the magazine out to put it back in. And there it is, just like that. Another thing you're gonna notice is on this receiver, I hate bases, okay? Because we're relying on Loctite, we're relying on 20-something inch pounds. The base here has actually been machined into the actual receiver itself. I think this is gonna be a zero taper. You're not gonna need, you know, 20 minutes of angle or anything like that for crazy long range shots, but that enables you to put your favorite rings, such as your Vortex Precision or any of the other common rings, onto here. You might have some issues with a spur. I don't know if a spur would make this gap here because it is rather long. The weight of this unit is going to come in somewhere around 3.2 kilograms or roughly 7 pounds. So while it's not the lightest thing out there, it is very, very robust. Now, depending on the optic you choose, you're probably looking at a total weight of about 11 pounds. It has a really good contour on the barrel, and I like the way that this rifle feels in the hands. It's just very comfortable. The trigger is super crisp. But enough talking, let's go ahead and shoot this on the range. We're gonna shoot it at 100 meters, and we're gonna see how it does in the 6.5 Creedmoor. Price point on this rifle should hit the US market for somewhere around $2,000. And a lot of you might say, well, $2,000 is a lot, but for a custom hunting rifle, especially with the straight pull design, that's within that price point. A little more expensive than the Savage, but a little less than some of the premium European brands that you don't normally see in the US. So let's go ahead and get rounds down range. All right, so it does hold five in the magazine. So I'm going to just put it in here and insert it. It is an empty bolt. We're gonna pretend we're going out hunting. We're gonna chamber the first round. I do have a camera down here that's sitting on a digital screen, so we should be able to see where the impact is. Remember, this is a brand new 6.5, so I don't know if it's been zeroed, but here we go. What I'll be doing is I'll be shooting for the green circle. It's an open circle. I want to make sure we're all looking at the same one. And I'll be shooting the Hornady, the Precision Hunter. This is 6.5 Creedmoor in the 143 grain ELDX. All right, so let me get centered up. Safety's off, but here we go. All right, very, very soft. I think we do need to zero the scope. We're a little bit high, but I'm not gonna change anything. I'm gonna leave it exactly where it's at. We'll follow that up with another round. Man, that's fast. We're gonna hold it like we're hunting, more of a hunting setup. I'll have my hand on the fore end. I think that's enough for now just to see. It is going to be sub MOA grouping. Guys, it's a hunting rifle. All right, so I think it's only fair to go ahead and switch ammunition. We're gonna still stick with Hornady. You guys know that I'm a huge proponent of Hornady ammunition. This is the Outfitter ammunition. This is the 120 grain GMX bullet. So much lighter weight, and it is in the 6.5 Creedmoor. We've got the action open on this one. I'll actually hold somewhere in here. And what I'll do is I will go for the red dot just to the right of the one that I just shot. Here we go. A little high and right. Every ammunition is going to be different. And last round. All right, so not bad. It's still gonna be somewhere around an inch or so, and I think that's perfectly acceptable. Guys, remember, we always talk about PRS. Inch is perfectly acceptable for about anything. Remember, we're not shooting, you know, little hummingbirds here. We're actually shooting big game or larger game. And so I think that was it for the Hornady.
That's it, I told you, 147 ELD.
All right, guys, so this is a 416 Rigby cartridge. I'm gonna hold it up to a 6.5 Creedmoor for comparison. In the LIWA action, so you can see it's a honking cartridge. This projectile weighs in at 400 grains. So let's see how Ray does with this. All right, so this would be equivalent to something that you would use for big or dangerous game. There is no scope on this. It does have irons. It's probably gonna rock me into tomorrow, but that's all right. It's all for you guys. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to aim at the bullseye. I do have a camera downrange. I hope this works pretty well. So here we go. I want a good shot on this. It's actually not bad at all. I don't even know if it hit the target. All right, so let's do it again. I'm gonna hold a little right on this one. Not too bad. All right, I'd hate to think of what this ammunition costs. It's probably like, I don't know, maybe $10 a round. It's not that bad, especially if you only needed one shot. But looking at the camera there, I would need to adjust the sight just a little bit. I think I've got to aim a little bit lower, but my left to right is actually pretty good. So Let's see if I can get one on the shoot and see here at 100 meters. Here we go. All right. All right, I hope you enjoyed that review of the Liwa Arms, the Cheyah Z20. This is a really, really nice rifle, and honestly, it would be a great option for me if I was hunting. I will tell you, it's not the lightest thing out there, but it is robust, has a solid feel to it, and that straight pull is just a really, really unique feel, and I think it'd be great for follow-up shots. I don't know if they're going to come out with any type of stainless finishes or composite stocks, but this is a beautiful stock and beautiful rifle to have in the collection. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. We'll be coming back at you with some more footage. You guys take care. Have a good one.